Days after the Supreme Court put a hold on the implementation of the three farm laws, the ninth round of talks between protesting farmers and the government is underway at Delhi's Vigyan Bhavan. Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar has said that he's hopeful that a deadlock with farmers will end soon. He also said that the government will put forth its view before the Supreme Court's appointed panel. According to sources, farmers have again rejected the government's proposal and are adamant that they won't accept anything less than the repeal of the laws. So far, farmers have met with the central government 8 times. A little headway has been achieved, but the biggest bone of contention remains the demand for the withdrawal of the laws as well as a guarantee on minimum support price. Farmer leader Rakesh Tikait has told India Today that they will not take out a tractor rally on Republic Day if the Supreme Court says so. Remember that on Jan 18th, the top court will hear a plea against the tractor rally that the farmers are planning.
पिछली बैठक और इस बैठक के बीच में उच्चतम न्यायालय का फैसला आया. भारत सरकार उच्चतम न्यायालय के फैसले का स्वागत करती है और उच्चतम न्यायालय ने जो समिति बनाई है वो समिति जब सरकार को बुलाएगी तो निश्चित रूप से हम अपना पक्ष उस समिति के सामने भी रखेंगे. चूंकि सरकार और किसानों के बीच में वार्ता चल रही है और इसलिए आज वार्ता की तारीख तय थी, तो किसानों के साथ वार्ता हमारी जारी है और हम लोग लगातार इस बात की कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि किसानों से चर्चा के माध्यम से कोई रास्ता निकल आए.
सुप्रीम कोर्ट की कमेटी बनी पर आप फिर भी सरकार के सामने आ रहे हैं, उस कमेटी के सामने क्यों नहीं जा रहे?
ना, सरकार के सामने जाएंगे, वो तो इन्होंने ही बनाई ना कानून.
सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने बनाई है?
नहीं नहीं, कानून तो इन्होंने बनाए, तो इन्हीं से बात करेंगे.
तो आपको लगता है कि उस कमेटी के सामने कोई पावर्स नहीं है, कुछ है नहीं, जाना बेफायदा है?
नहीं, हम नहीं जा रहे. पावर तो है, बड़ी पावर होती है, लेकिन हम नहीं जा रहे.
क्यों, वजह क्या है? सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने अपॉइंट किया,
वो तो जो सारे के सारे लोग हैं वे पहले ही बिल का समर्थन कर रहे हैं. लाल कपड़े पहन के समर्थन करने वाले तो हमारे खिलाफ जाएंगे. तो हम तो इंतजार करेंगे, इसके आंदोलन का रिजल्ट का इंतजार करेंगे. हम बगैर इलाज के जाएंगे नहीं यहाँ से.
26 जनवरी को क्या होगा?
26 जनवरी को तो आएंगे
दिल्ली, अगर आपको पुलिस ने आने नहीं दिया.
पुलिस से तो हम रुकते नहीं, कोर्ट ने कुछ कह दिया बात मानेंगे, पुलिस तो हमारे साथ में है.
अच्छा, कोर्ट ने अगर कह दिया कि आप परेड नहीं ला सकते दिल्ली में, तो मान जाएंगे?
मान लेंगे, मान जाएंगे, उनकी बात मान लेंगे.
7 मंथ से वी से वी विल नॉट गो बिफोर एनी कमिटी बिकॉज इट बिटवीन गवर्नमेंट एंड फार्मर्स. डायरेक्ट थिंग्स आर देयर. Why will what 4 member, why Pradhan Mantri cannot take a decision? What 4 members of junior people will take a decision? They cannot do anything. And they are all agent of the corporate houses. Now, it is proved. We said we don't, we want the government. It is them to correct it. And we want, this is our only demand that ओनली रिपील, देयर इज नो अदर वे.
जी, आज की मीटिंग है उससे हमको कोई उम्मीद नहीं है, बेमीदी है, बेमीदी है. वही जो 8 मीटिंगों का रिजल्ट निकला है, नतीजा निकला है, वही नतीजा इसका निकलेगा. क्योंकि सरकार की नीत और नीति जो है वो साफ नहीं है बिल्कुल. तीनों खेती कानून रद्द करने के नहीं है और MSP के गारंटी वाला कानून जो 23 फसलों का है वो नहीं बनाने का है.
देखो, जाते तो हमेशा उम्मीद से ही है, आज भी उम्मीद रखेंगे. तो सरकार हमको क्या देती है देखेंगे. हम तो हर मीटिंग में, किसी मीटिंग में ऐसा गए नहीं है कि हमको उम्मीद नहीं है. तो केस तो हमारा बड़ा स्पष्ट है, आपको पता ही है सबसे पहले कि हम रिपील से नीचे तो कोई मानने वाले हैं नहीं.
तो कोई खास नहीं होगा आज, हम तो इसलिए जा रहे हैं कि सरकार ये ना बताए कि किसान बातचीत करने नहीं आए हैं. सुप्रीम कोर्ट की कमेटी, उसको हमने रद्द कर दिया है, जो स्टे लगाया है उसको हम नहीं मानते, हम रिपील करने की मांग करते हैं.
Let me take this across now to Paulmi Saha for all the latest updates. So Paulmi, the meeting is underway. Does look unlikely that we can really expect any headway or any breakthrough, because sources are telling us that it's clear that the bone of contention, that the biggest issue between the two sides remains on the rollback and nothing's changed on that front.
Well, absolutely, Akshita. Nothing's changed on that front. The farmers are adamant that nothing short of a repeal will in fact convince them to call off their agitation. And that is exactly what they're demanding in this meeting with the central government ministers, which is currently underway at Vigyan Bhavan. The centre has again proposed making changes and amendments to the three central farm laws. But again, those that proposal stands rejected by the farmers. They do not want to go before the Supreme Court committee, notwithstanding the fact that one of the members of the committee has already recused himself from the committee. But they believe that that committee has no powers in order to meet their demands. That committee cannot repeal the laws. The laws have been formulated by the central government, and it is only the central government that can meet their demands. So they're quite adamant that nothing short of a rollback will in fact convince them to call off the agitation, like I said.
Let me also take this across to our National Affairs Editor, Rahul Srivastava. Rahul, how does this play out now? Considering that this is the first round of talks after the Supreme Court also went ahead and formed a committee, put a hold on the farm laws, you'd think that maybe something's changed, but it's clear nothing has. Both sides are sticking to the same stand as before. The demands are the same. The central government stand is the same. How will things go on from here?
Akshita, with the breakdown of talks between the government and the farmers, with no point of convergence emerging, the Supreme Court's olive branch in form of putting the laws on an interim hold, one, and second, stating that the MSP will continue as earlier, lands of farmers will not be seized, an olive branch was extended and a window of opportunity was opened in form of a panel. Now, the Supreme Court appointed four people. The key person, as far as the present protesting lot at the borders of Delhi, the BKU leader, Mr. Mann, moved out following the pressure from the farm unions. And after that, the Supreme Court will have to go back to the drawing board in terms of reconstituting the committee or perhaps deciding whatever the Supreme Court does. Eventually, it's back to square one as far as that window of opportunity is concerned. Now, while this, while the farmers seem to have had a disadvantageous position, they seem to have restored the status quo ante by Mr. Mann moving out of the committee. Now, when they come to the government, initially there were fears among the farmers that with the Supreme Court appointing a committee, the government will say that either you talk to us and what we are offering in terms of amendments, please accept that or go to the committee. That the farmers hoped would actually make them in a slightly more disadvantageous position. But the problem here is now, with the Supreme Court having set up a window of opportunity, does the government have a great amount of elbow room to continue negotiation with the farmers? Because the Supreme Court has already mandated a committee. In that scenario, it could well be the possibility that government may not be more keen to talk to the farm unions, primarily because it wanted to get the issue off its own shoulders. And it had gone to the Supreme Court with primarily that motive. Now, with the Supreme Court into the picture, the government may not be interested beyond today's meeting to actually go ahead and continue talking to the farm unions. In that, there is a disadvantage that there were certain peripheral issues beyond the three farm laws that the farm government was ready to make concessions. Even that issue, the government may not be largely keen to talk to the farmers if they continue that strident posture that the farm bills should be and farm laws should be repealed.
Okay, Rahul and Paulmi, thank you for joining us with the latest on this latest round of talks.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.